Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. My dear children, how are you? Lots of du'as for your iman, for your easy life, for your success in both the worlds. Ameen. Okay, let's say the du'a, which is going to make it easy for me to tell you things, and it is going to make it easy for you to understand. And that is, Rabbi shrahli sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Rabbana zidna ilma. Ameen. Okay, my dear children, as you know that in Quran there are 114 surahs, like the chapters are 114, and in those surahs, Surah Baqarah is the longest one, and in Surah Baqarah there is an ayah which is the greatest ayah of Quran, the greatest ayah of Quran. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the greatest, is being mentioned in it, right? You know what? It is the introduction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We wish to know about our Creator, and we want to know what are the attributes, what are the qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we know about our God, then we get stronger in our faith, in our confidence, and we become brave. Because we know that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us, then we are good to go. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the greatest powers, and He loves us so much. And if He is with us, then we don't have to be afraid of anything, right? Ayat al-Kursi has Allah's names and Allah's attributes in it. So shaitan is scared of Allah's name. Wherever we read Allah's name, shaitan runs away. And Ayat al-Kursi is the best way to keep him away, right? As you know, the shaitan is there to bother us, to scare us, and he tries to harm us. But if we read Ayat al-Kursi, he cannot bother us anymore. My dear children, there are a few hadith about Ayat al-Kursi, which Prophet ﷺ told us. But let's see. Do you know what is the meaning of hadith? Hadith is the words, the actions, and the silent approvals of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, Papa, you should know this, that what is a hadith? If someone asks, what is a hadith? These are the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the action of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the silent approval of our dear Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, let's see what does the hadith tell us. That Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that if anyone who is about to go to sleep reads Ayat al-Kursi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appoints a guard for that person, and he protects from shaitan till the dawn, right? So all those people who get scared at night or who get scary dreams, they should be very, very punctual about it, that they should read Ayat al-Kursi before going to bed. And every single person should do that. Okay, and now we have learned about Salah as well. And you know that right after Fard Salah, without talking, without saying any other word, we should say Allahu Akbar, Astaghfirullah, 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 and then read Ayat al-Kursi. Because this is a deed which can take you to Jannah, right? I hope that everyone has already memorized Ayat al-Kursi. But if you haven't done it, do it now, because it is really beneficial, right? Because it is for our own protection. Once there was a companion of the Prophet ﷺ, his name was Ubay bin Ka'b. And Prophet ﷺ asked him, do you know, Abu Munzir, which is the greatest ayah of Quran, in the whole Quran? He, after asking two times, he said, oh, Prophet of Allah, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. Prophet ﷺ pat on his chest and said, congratulations for the knowledge that you have. So that means that Ayat al-Kursi is really beneficial. And I'm going to tell you one story as well. This story is from this era. It's not a very old story. That there was a girl, and she got to know that there was a man who attacked a girl, and she had to take the same way to go home. And she got late from school, and she was scared. But she started to read Ayat al-Kursi because she knew that this is for the protection. So she kept on reading, and right then she saw a man, a huge man, coming towards her. And he started to come closer and closer, and she was scared, and she kept on reading Ayat al-Kursi. And the man just passed without saying anything to her. And then she called the police and she told that the place where the other girl got attacked, there was a man over there. I saw the same type of man that was described by the other girl. So the police took him in, and the girl identified him and said that yes, that's the man. And the police asked the man, why didn't you attack this girl while you attacked the other girl? And he said, how could I attack her? Because there were two huge men walking with her. And the girl said, no, I was alone. And right then, she just realized that she was reading Ayatul Kursi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala must have sent protection for her. So subhanallah, whenever we are leaving the house, whenever we are scared, we are in need of protection, we are in need of help, we should read Ayatul Kursi, right? Okay, my dear children, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.